Hi, welcome back. This is Rakesh Nair. Today we are going to discuss about divide and conquer. But before we start, a small information I'd like to say. In this channel, we produce every video in two different languages. If you want to watch this video in Hindi, kindly follow the link given in the description. And if you have not yet subscribed, please subscribe and press the bell icon so that you will get regular updates from this channel. So, let us start. In our previous videos, we have seen what is an algorithm, what are the characteristics of an algorithm, how to find time complexity of an algorithm, and all this. In this video, we are going to take a concept that is divide and conquer. It is a problem-solving technique. So let us see. Basically, the name divide and conquer applied to the algorithm that reduces the problem into sub-problem. And we solve the problem by using top-down approach. Basically, divide and conquer algorithm works recursively, breaking the problem into two or more sub-problems of same type. And we keep on subdividing the problem till the problem is simple enough to solve directly. For example, let us say binary search. Binary search is the best example for divide and conquer. Let us see. In binary search, we are given a sorted data, either in ascending or descending order. And we want to search a particular element. So we are having a search element. What we do, we try to find the mid value and compare the mid value with the searched value. Depending on whether the mid value is greater than or less than the searched value, we will discard a part of it, either left hand side or right hand side. So our problem domain reduced by half. If I find the data that I am searching is on the left hand side of the data, then I'll just ignore the right hand side data. So my problem domain reduced by half. So in this way, I'm going to search my element. So the bigger problem becomes a smaller problem, and then smaller problem, and then smaller problem, till I find the data. So this is the basic approach of any divide and conquer method. And we do it recursively. Let us see what are the basic steps we are going to apply for divide and conquer. The first step is divide. It means breaking the problem into sub-problem that are smaller instances of the same problem. The next step is conquer. Here, we solve the sub-problem recursively. And the third step is combine. After finding the smallest problem, we combine all the sub-problems to find the solution of the original problem. So if I want to write it in the form of algorithm, it will look like this. Algorithm, divide and conquer, where n is the number of element in which I am going to apply divide and conquer algorithm. If n is small enough, then I'll apply divide and conquer and find the solution for this particular problem and I'll return it. Otherwise, if n is big enough, then I'll divide n into smaller sub-problems like n1, n2 up to nk. Then for each ni, I'll apply divide and conquer algorithm. And at last, I'll combine the result of divide and conquer of n1, divide and conquer of n2, divide and conquer of nk. It may happen this n1 is still bigger. Again, I'll subdivide. So this process will be continuing till I find the result. Let us see how to find the complexity of any divide and conquer problem. Let us say n1, n2, nk with the size of k sub-problems. If n is small enough, then gn can be its complexity, let us say. Otherwise, I have to find the complexity of n1. Plus the complexity of n2 plus the complexity of nk. This way I have to find. When I am doing plus on time complexity, it is nothing but maximum of t of n1, t of n2, t of nk. So this is how I will be finding in general the time complexity of any divide and conquer problem. The divide and conquer algorithm typically have the time complexity of recurrence relation for. For tn, If n is small, let us say t1 is the complexity. Otherwise, I have to write it in this form. It means a t n by b plus fn. What is a? A is the number of sub-problem I am having, and b is the size of each problem, and fn is the time required to combine all the sub-problems. So this is the general way of writing the recurrence relation for any divide and conquer algorithm. There are many methods we are having to find time complexity of recurrence relation. We have already seen substitution method, master method and tree method. These are the three methods we are having to find time complexity of a recurrence relation. Any method I will adopt and find the time complexity. Let us see the advantages of having divide and conquer algorithm. The first advantage is solving the problem is difficult. When n is too large, solving it is really, really difficult. Instead of that, if we break the bigger problem into smaller sub-problem, then it becomes easier to approach the same problem with a lesser number of data. So it becomes easier to solve by divide and conquer method. The second one is algorithm efficiency. Often we find it easy to solve any problem by divide and conquer method because we use recursion. The next one is parallelism. As we have already told that divide and conquer algorithm breaks the problem into sub-problems. So if it is required to solve all the sub-problems and if the partitions are mutually exclusive, then I can separately solve each and every problem separately. So it means I can do all the works of each and every sub-problem parallelly. So parallelism is possible when I am applying divide and conquer method. Memory access. Divide and conquer algorithm naturally tend to make efficient use of memory cache. Why? Why? Because we are using recursion, and in recursion, memory access is very, very efficient. Next one is round of control. It means divide and conquer may yield more accurate result than any iterative method. So these are the basic advantages for which we apply any divide and conquer algorithm. Then what are the implementation issues? That also we must address. The first issue is a recursion. Whenever we are applying divide and conquer, then we have to use recursion. Unless we are having a good grip over recursive procedure, we are not in a position to apply divide and conquer efficiently. The next one is explicit stack. As we have already told that divide and conquer method uses recursive procedure, so obviously memory I will be using in the form of stack. If an explicit stack is defined, then it becomes easier for me to apply recursive procedure. Next one is stack size. Divide and conquer algorithm are time efficient, often have relatively small recursion depth. The smaller the recursion depth, the more the efficient algorithm. It means I need the lesser size of the stack. And if I am having lesser size of stack, I need not define explicit stack at all. The next thing is about choosing the base case. Choosing the base case is an important aspect when we are talking about recursive procedure. Why? Because this is the point where I am saying how the problem will be terminating. The next issue is sharing repeated subproblem. It means sometimes it may happen that same subproblem is appearing again and again. Instead of calculating it again and again, if we keep the data in a tabular form, then we can reuse it whenever it is required. So these are the basic implementation issues that we must address while implementing divide and conquer. And the basic applications are binary search, merge sort, quick sort, stress and matrix multiplication, and there are many more. I hope you understood what is divide and conquer method, how to apply divide and conquer method, what is the basic approach to find time complexity in a divide and conquer method. So if you understood, give me a like and share among your friends. In our next video, we are going to talk about some application of divide and conquer. See you then. Take care. Bye.